How y'all doing out there? This is Tony from Hippie Vapes, and thanks for joining my group or watching. Let me take up a little bit of your time, because there's a lot of people out there, new beginning vapers, that are curious. You know, I want to teach you how to save some money, a whole lot of money. So let me just start out. You know, when you first started vaping, let's say you're a vapor now. And I mean, when I started out, I got one of these suckers, you know, a Kanger Evod, believe it or not, when I first started it out. And that sucker, man, blew my mind. I mean, as soon as I picked this up, I quit smoking that very day. You know, since then, I've progressed, all right? So I needed something with a little bit more, looked like smoke to me back then, you know, but it was vapor. So I found this, the Kanger Subbox Mini. And back then at the store, at the vape store, they were wanting, I think it was like $125 for this sucker. This is the kit. This came with the tank and the mod. But this one only went up to 50 watts, you know. But the tank, it came with pre-built coils, or it also came with an RBA section. Oh yes, that's what I was looking for. So I could build my own coils. Because those coils, that pre-built ones, you know, man, they cost a lot of money per coil. You go to vape store, they just charge you out the rear end. Well, I got a little trick, you know, to save you a little money on those. All right, let's say you got a tank, you know, that doesn't have an RBA section. You know, there's that Star Pro. I hardly ever use it because there's no RBA section on it, and I just don't like it, really. Well, it comes with, you know, little coils like that. And it comes with nickel, titanium coil, I think. And then I went to the store and bought one of their Canthal coils, you know. And it was maybe lasted 2 weeks before it just started not wanting to fire right. It just wouldn't taste right. It tasted funny. You can tell it was all gunked up, you know. So what you do when that happens is you take that coil and you take you a little plastic bowl like this and you drop it in the bowl, okay? You just take your coil. If I can get the thing open. There we go. Just take your coil, drop it in the bucket, put you about 6 caps of rubbing alcohol in there, and then fill it the rest of the water with as hot as water as you can get from the tap. Okay, and then cover the coil with the water. Stir it up, mix up your water and your alcohol. Okay, but first, you know, first you can just take that coil and stick it underneath the faucet as hot as you can stand it with your fingers and hold it and let that water run straight through the coil, and you're cleaning that cotton out is what you're doing. You're cleaning the cotton out. All right, well, after you run it through the water and everything, you know, you take it and you close the, this one has 4 holes. You close the 4 holes, you blow on it, and you blow all that juice, that water out of there, you know, and then you stick it in your solution there and let it sit there overnight. That's all you do. Then the next morning, you take it and you stick it underneath the hot water again. You rinse it out real good. You blow through it. You get as much of the water out of the cotton as you can, okay? And you just let it dry for 24 hours. And that coil's almost just like it's brand new. Okay? That's on those kind of coils. I don't like those because you're still, I mean, you can make it last for one coil, I think, about a month, you know? But still, you know, I can't get the flavor I was looking for, you know, in them kind of coils. So, I like the RBA sections. Or don't be scared of RBA sections and all that. You know, it's really, really simple. And one of my drippers, I'm wanting to put a new coil on today. So I'm going to show you how to build a coil. It's a real simple coil. You got two kinds of coils. You got a contact coil and you got a spaced coil. Or you got claptons and all that too, you know, fancy stuff. Well, I can do all of them also. Sorry, leaking my fingers, man. Sticky. I was touching that coal. Had some Blue Falcon juice on it. All right, we're going to drop down. All right. Let's drop down here and turn the light on. Oh, wrong way. There we go. All right. Let's get it right over here. Oh, almost fell over. There we go. All right. You can buy spools of wire online, real cheap. This one, I think, was $3 and something for 100 foot of 26 gauge campball wire. Okay, comes in a spool just like this. This is the kind of spool you've seen on my little trick to make claptons and everything. All right, so you pull your piece of wire off, you know, off your spool. You're gonna need some clippers, okay, some wire cutters, clippers. You're going to need a screwdriver, okay? This is one in a regular old screwdriver that's got the flat head on it, you know, so it's smooth, so your coil can slide off. Or you can buy the coil vaping kit by Coil Master, you know. I use a 3mm bit because I'm building on a big deck here. Let's see, which one was I going to do? Oh, I wanted to do this one. Let me get it off here. This is that Petri from Dot Mod. Man, this is my flavor tank right here. I love this damn tank. Oh, there's the top. There's the bottom. Get that to the side. See, I'm going to take these off. These right here and just... Nah. There we go. They're just burnt out. Those were claptons on there. So you take your thing. On this one, it's real easy. I'm just giving you an idea how you build your coil and all that. So let's get that set up. Let's see here. Let me take my jig here. Take your wire. And you hold it. Well, I'm going to do it on a screwdriver, so... You know, just in case you don't have that Coil Master. You grab your wire, hold it just like this, and you count six wraps. I'm going to do six wraps on this one. All right, so that would be one wrap. And try to keep it as tight and close to that other wrap that you just did also. There's two, three, four, five, six. Okay. Take the fingernail and you just pinch it down just like that. Right. And you let go of that one right there. Bend it over a little bit. Then press down on it. Or actually, you take your pair of pliers and just pull it tight. Holding the other side so it doesn't, you know, spin back on you. All right, just like that. There's one coil. All right, that's all she wrote. That's it. Wow, that was easy as hell. Now let's cut this thing right there. Boom. There's one coil. Simple as that. See how easy that was? All right, there's a dual coil, so I got to make two of them. Now, I did that six wraps on that one, so I got to do six wraps on this one, too. See, there's one, two, three, four, five, six. Squeeze it down a little bit. Take my pliers. Good. grab that piece, pull it tight a little bit. Boom, there you go. There's your second coil. Wow. All right, put your wire away. I'm gonna grab my Phillips head screwdriver because on this one right here, this is a cool RDA. I love this thing, the way it's made. Unscrew your top two screws, and the whole thing should just slide right out. I'm not even going to take the cotton out. All the coils should just pop right out. See, boom. There it is right there. There's the old coil. Throw that sucker away. Because I'm not saving that one. That coil seen a better day. Let's pull the second one out. Get rid of it. Alright, now you got your deck. Alright, love this deck. I got two post holes on this one. Okay. So, one's positive and one's negative. Alright. So, I'm taking one of the coals and I'm sticking one leg in one hole, the other leg in the other hole. And get them in there. There's that one. Well, almost had it. There we go. Here's where I need my magnifying glasses. My glasses just, ain't the best in the world. This one, you gotta put both coils in at the same time because you're screws hold both coils. Man, I ain't heard that in a long time. The best way to do this is take your screwdriver, get it in there, pull that wire to the right, pull this one over this way. That way, that coil is going to stay there in that position for a little while until I get the other one where I want it. Save yourself a lot of time. Have your coil already right where you want it. And, before you tighten it down, can't see the hole. Right, there we go. All right. That one out. All right. Now, I'm going to cheat. I'm going to grab a second screwdriver. See, I know it's 3 millimeters. I'm going to make sure both coils are right where I need them before I even tighten them down. See, this is just peaceful. It takes your mind away. Tighten them down just a little bit. All right. Now you see how I've got them. Now here's where you can work them. Alright, you take your screwdriver and you pull out a little bit. You pinch in. You pull out and up. Oh yeah, that looks good. That looks real good. Let's get this other one. Stick the screwdriver in it. Pull it out. Oh, see, that one's not tightened down all the way. That's got to get tight some more. then you look at it to see if it's even, and it's not quite even, so I've got to pull this one up a little bit. See that? Stick the screwdriver back in it, pull it up just a hair, so it's even with the other one. Yeah, that looks good. A little bit more. Trying to get my screwdriver back in. There we go. Where's my pliers? That sucker needs to be tight enough. Better be now. Yeah. Break out magnifying glass. It's this. You gotta look exactly where your leads are, so you cut your leads off. Hold them for sure, because they'll fly everywhere. Definitely don't want to step on a piece of wire. You know what I mean? That shit kind of hurt, wouldn't it? It does. I've stepped on one before. You live and you learn. I'm just teaching you a quick, easy, simple build here. Oh, there's one leg right there. That should be all of them. Alright, now let's see what ohm we're at. It came out to a 0.4 ohm coil. Let's go ahead and tighten up both of them. That one. That one. That looks pretty good. Not bad. Unscrew it off the base. Now I'm going to put it on my IPv3 Li. I love this device here. This is one of the, I upgraded it to 200 watts. Even it does all stainless steel, titanium. But I just use Campbell. I like it. Just regular wattage mode, especially for a dripper. All right, now let's sit there. Alright, I'm going to start pulsing it now. What watt we got on? Let me drop that sucker down. I'm going to definitely drop it down. Drop it down. 25 watts. And fire it. You'll get it glowing. See it glowing? Alright, take your screwdriver that you built the coil with and just strum them just a little bit like the guitar. Alright, pulse again. And they should burn from the inside out. See, that one's starting off a little quicker than the other one. And stretch them a little more. There we go. Now it's doing the See, you want them to glow at the same time, same rate of speed. Oh yeah. Cool them off. Oh yeah, them some pretty cool. Alright, now let's throw some cotton in it. Dang, that sounded like one of my older videos. Didn't know it was on my playlist. Let's get some cotton bacon here. I used version 2 cotton bacon. This stuff right here. I just like it. There's no break in on it. Get you enough to go in there tight, snug, but not too snug, you know. Love this stuff. Oh, I ain't heard that long song.
Don't take to heart the words that he said. I know you're a good girl. You're not out to hurt nobody. He's just trying to get, trying to get in your head.
There's one side.
Baby, if you want to
come. The other side.
Come over. Come over and get high. We can listen to the dark side. If you wanna come over and get high. We can listen to the dark side. Hey, 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 my friend. Are you at it again? I think. You hold your heart too close to the vest. I know you're a good man. You're not out to hurt nobody. She's just trying to get in your head.
Oh. Just stuff it right down in the bottom. Make sure your cotton's not touching the bottom of your coal, though.
Come over and get high.
Because you want that airflow to go underneath the coal and all around it. You know?
Come over.
This is my flavor, Addy.
I mean,
the flavor off this thing is just phenomenal.
And I won't have.
See how relaxing this is? I love building.
The right words to say.
It's like I zone out sometimes.
It's just no.
I like to get it perfect. And, I actually don't have as much cotton in this side as I do the other, but it should work okay. Alright, now there's that.
Hey, Abigail.
Put the cotton in it.
Today has been hell good.
Okay.
Don't take to heart the words that he said. I know you're a good girl. You're not out to hurt nobody.
All right. Now let's take this bad boy and let's throw some dripping water on there. One of my own homemade flavors I do. I got so many recipes. All right, let's cut off all these lights so you can see better.
Come over and get high.
We're gonna take this sucker.
Dark side of me.
Gonna start
if you wanna
getting the wicks real soaking wet.
Come over and get high. We can listen to the dark side. If you wanna come over.
Hold the fire a little bit. You see a little bit of smoke on paper.
High.
gonna come that way it gets inside that cotton really, really, really good. And get high. If you wanna and come I've been waiting over. To try this one. Come yeah, get it good and juiced up. So all your wig is wet. That should be good. Let's put the top on this bad boy. You want your holes on your cap to be right next to your coals. So if you look through that hole, you'll see the coal in there actually. That's perfect placement of that coal. Let's go up top. Oh, let me turn the volume up. Oh, ooh, man, that's tasting good. Let's move that volume up. The wattage I'm talking about. I'm gonna put. I always put mine at 3.7. I like it there. That's where my maximum flavor really is. So this one at 3.7. It's coming out 32.6 watts on this coil I built. Oh yeah. Now that tastes good. Now that's a well built coal. I sure do appreciate y'all watching. And that's the easiest coal you can build. That was just a that wasn't even contact, that was a space coal. You know? Now, if I had did the contact, which I could do that one in another video, but for now, you know, it's real easy to get into building. It's a lot cheaper. I mean, that coal I just built will last me about 2-3 months, the wire, and maybe even longer. I can do one even longer. Like, I'm going to show you how to clean these coals where you just dip them in water. That's it. Simple as that. Look, he'll be all stretched out. He loves it when I do videos. He gets to sleep. All right. Well, y'all have a good one. And see you on the next video. Peace, love, and harmony.